Wale ni vijana barubari, naitwa vijana barubari. Mashmwana fale akimalizia with a song that I even forgotten his name. Sorry Mash. For Simba wa Yuda. Sorry Mashmwana. Najua utakutana mimi uniulize. But anyway, as people are sending in their messages, there's this message that I've liked pale on our social media. Anajita John Mwanda Wiro. Happy Father's Day to my daddy, Sir Joseph Mwanzuna Malegua. Huyo saa haongei wala hasiki, lakini kwa hii dunia hakuna mwingine kama yeye. Alinifunza maisha, niko vile nilivyo sababu yake. Patrick Zigani, John Mwagura, Mwakio Mwanzala, fikishieni salamu zangu za Father's Day. Alafu akapiga picha yake pale na babake. Ah, wonderful. This is such a beautiful message. Indeed, happy Father's Day to you, babake John. Happy Father's Day to you. And speaking of fathers, today we've been have a great, great opportunity. We've been graced by a wonderful Father's Day. Nasema every single Sunday is usually special, and today is a special edition, and we have an amazing man of God who has joined us today. Anajiita Chris Ngao. Of course, his journey is amazing. I want you to sit there carefully and just listen to what he will share with us today, because you know what, towards this day I've just been praying for people that whoever will tune in, this message may heal them, may restore the joy in their heart, may they lift up from whatever ashes they have been hiding into, so that you can enjoy the glory of God in their lives. So Chris Ngao, karibu sana mtu wa Mungu. Siku nyingi asifu.
Nashukuru, nashukuru.
Ukoje?
Niko fit sana.
Happy Father's Day to you.
Thank you, thank you.
How does it feel to be told like that?
Inakuja mzuri.
Thank
you so much.
Who is Chris Ngao? Give you opportunity to introduce.
Wow. Chris Ngao is a young man, a father, married to one wife.
Yes.
Blessed with two sons. Currently, we have one. Yes. I'll give the story later.
Yes.
I come from Makueni by there. Wakamba tuko locked mbaya.
Nikuze word moja kikamba.
Oh my goodness.
Ya salamu.
Ya salamu.
The easiest one.
The easiest. The easiest ni gani sasa?
Salamu wa mnasalamiana aje.
Upoa wako. Upoa wako nikuuliza uko aje.
Niko poa.
Uko fit. Sasa niulize na kikamba.
Ovo waku.
Ni museo.
Ni museo.
Yes, yes.
You see?
Yeah, so so I currently reside in Nairobi. And I'm born again. Yes, yes.
Salvation.
Yeah, kabisa.
Tupige story ya salvation. Mepeleka aje?
Iko fiti, but one thing I normally say about salvation, you see, nasemanga mse, wacha nisi kudanganye. It's not as easy as people think, but it's the best experience because it has a reward. It's only life with a reward.
Yes.
Yeah. Imagine living knowing one time. Yeah. So it's amazing. It's been cool. Tunashukuru Mungu.
Chris, there's something that there's just the Spirit has told me. You're young, you're born again, and you're married. And you're married the right way. Tell me about it.
Let me say this.
Young, born again. Hizo combination words, it makes sense kwa generation yetu. Mse umeokoka, unapenda Christ.
Yeah.
Wewe ni young. And besides that, ukamua ile come, we try and see if things will work. If they don't work, kila mtu ashike nje yake. But let us go before God and enter the covenant of marriage.
Let me say
this. Why did you choose this path?
Before even I get there, let me appreciate my wife, Eva. She's called Eva.
Yes.
I know she's maybe watching. Najua tuko na kama junior pale, maybe
anakula
chakula yake. But I want to appreciate her. It's been amazing. Let me put this clear.
Yes.
Personally, I'm married. I'm happy in my marriage.
Yes.
You know, it's been trending. I know I've been vocal about it when it comes to marriages working or not working. And I think personally, it's a choice. Someone else's marriage not to work is not yours. So I would say mine is working, and we are very happy. It's a good thing to live to fulfill scripture that or we read that father began, that is marriage, because God is the author, he's the one who began marriage.
Yes.
It's amazing to live to fulfill that scripture.
Yeah, Rusi ilikuwa fiti.
Pale
Garden of Eden.
Nakwambia.
Ilikuwa fiti.
So it's a blessing to be young, full of the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
Find the right person, because you can't have a good family or good marriage without finding the right person. Find the right person, and then now enter into this thing. It's amazing. It's cool.
Kuna blessings inakuja hapo.
Wacha tuniulize.
Wacha nikuulize. Si umesema nikuulize? Haya, nimekuuliza. Hizi blessings za marriage na mafavor ni nini? Compare to your life as a single person. Now you are now a married man.
Let me refer to the word, because this is what keeps us. Bible in the Sema, he who finds a wife gets a good thing and obtains favor from the Lord. Let me speak about a thing. The Bible doesn't say that he who finds a wife, they go and pray for a good thing. these are packages which come with marriage. So you obtain it by default. That one, you don't pray. You don't pray for the blessing. So long as you are aware that there's a that's good thing, and I mean there's the good thing, because the wife is not a thing, but there's a package in a woman. Yeah, there's a package in a woman, and so the other thing is favor. My friend, nikiku, ukiona photo zangu nikiwa single.
Squeezy
tunaona kuna evidence, tunaona vitu mingi zina come through, and we thank God. Yeah. So there's favor which comes with marriage. There's some just which comes. Aso tulikuwa tunapiga manzee, squeezy vitu zinasonga.
Zinajipa. Shughuli zinajipa.
Fanya hivi.
Advice kijana. Mwenye ana feel shortcut ndio kusema. I love you generation, but they, wasi wana come, we try wengi. Wanaona hii process haibambi.
Me, I would say this. I like being real, because unajua tuna sisi kazi yetu ni kuongelesha vijana. One thing I would say, it's nita compare na what is happening today in our daily work.
Yes.
So many marriages in a break. Unfortunately, even vocal people and people who maybe we know, and they're loud out there, and it gets into that system of young men that or young people that if this is what is happening in the marriage scene, I rather stay single.
Yeah.
Or rather, I better have someone, we stay together, and nione kama itawak. Then isipo work, I will do this thing. So I would say that wasn't your marriage. Trust God. Pray for your own wife or husband. And Mr. Kwenjo, you might not hear the voice telling you, I am the Lord your God. Miriam or ABCD is your wife or your husband. You might not hear that, but there are things there's a peace that comes with what is in the will of God. So just pray, trust God, and achana zinyazijawak, iyo si yako. You trust God.
Yes.
Get into it. Put your feet in it. And if you are where God, I mean God for a good wife or a good husband, then go the right way. Because even though Tsu Sema, allow me just say this one more thing. That whatever which was your was a witness in that day of agreement and in that moment, season of in that time of covenant, is the same one you're gonna call when shakeups come. And so my prayer is that make sure pastor, a priest is a witness, and as well God is witness, so that you may go back to him in case
shake-ups
juu zitakam. Hata mimi nimekuwa nazo.
Let us get into that conversation, Chris.
Yeah.
Nakumbuka, I know the day now, the blessings of marriage inakuanga. Watoto, hata sons inatuambia. Blessed is the man who has so many of them, He's blessed. Chris, now this day. How did you feel when your wife now told you, Maze, are we expectant? Yes.
I think this was back in 2020. Well, I got married in 2019. Yeah, Mwezi wa nane. The other day I had forgotten. I did an interview somewhere and I forgot the date. So
God,
it was fight. Sasa hii nimeandika Mwezi wa nane 31st.
I wish Eva was here.
Nilisahau date. So that, but in 2021, God blessed us. Of course, I remember that we agreed to tupate mtoi. You see, usema, in that
let us work together.
In that moment, you plan. Yeah, and so it was a blessing to get the news, one, and also in the time of, you know, receiving our gift, it was such a blessing.
And the baby came.
The baby came, and it was amazing. Yeah,
that process must be nice.
Of course, it was so good. Nikaenda hosi tukachukua mtoi, nikachukua mtoi because najua nilikuwa na wife tu hapo. Mimi sitadanganya siku ingie kwa labor. Whatever, mimi nilikaa pali yangu ningoje.
And dad, so, first time dad.
Yeah.
That
it was so amazing. Yeah. Although sikuwa na believe by then. Nilikuwa naona kama ni jokes. Nilikuwa nakaa tu jokes, but it can hit.
Yes.
Yeah.
Now what happened from there? You are in the hospital, you've taken the child, you received now your gift. God has given you this wonderful gift. It is usually a privilege to have a child.
Sure.
God trust you with this blessing. Ati, hey, Chris, maze, nilele mtoto wangu.
It's kama story ya Hana.
Nilele mtoto wangu. So you have this kid, you child, you go with them at home. Take us through that. Now, what happened next? And how did that sit with you?
I know the story might take a turn kidogo, I think we'll bend now too. Well, I think it was amazing.
And this child had a name.
Yeah.
Yes.
My firstborn was called Jason. Jason, not Jason, but Jason. He was called Jason, and he came. We stayed with him for 5 days, and on the 6th day, something happened. Then we lost him. Tukumpotezea hosi. I was coming from work one evening. And then, of course, my wife called. Okay, I was nilikuwa na unishipenda mtoi mpaka. I was the one who used to kumpanguza tu, you know, alale jioni, you know. It was an amazing task. So I just called my wife, nikamwambia. Then I was living in Kawe. So what I did say, because I'm not living now there now.
Yes.
I was living in Kawe. So I called them, because we know referral. I was there, I was just driving home.
Yes.
So nikamwambia niaje, mnyonyeshe. Ndio nikifika, tukimpanguza ata dozo. Of course, niwa toiwa ki. So that's what I did. So from Rifaro to Kawa West is around 1 to 2 kilometers. As well, by the time I was just parking, my wife calls me. And she tells me, niaje, mtoi Jason amekuwa msik. So nikamuliza how. So I did that haraka, nikaingia kwa nyumba. And then I got there. We were living in the same flat with my sister, called Miriam. Somewhere chini. And so, nikaingia kwa nyumba. I just found them. They have kept my son somewhere in a coach. And now they are looking at me. No one is saying anything. So I picked the baby and I tried to, unajua unashika-shika, and the baby was very, according to me, the baby was okay. Aikuwa inani hit, something can happen. See, mtoto amekuwa mgonjwa, so I expect to pick, to mkimbiza osi and stuff. And so I took the baby and I tried to, unajua unashika-shika, you know, your joto na nini, I tried to do that, and then something told me, apana, let me know whether anapumua. So nikamchukua hivi. Nikatoa hizo manguo alikuwa amenijia mtoto anafunikwa sana, and then nikamweka hapa. So I wanted to feel kama anani breathe here. Hiyo breathing ina nini. So I think I felt cold lips. Something hit me. And it's when I realized that the son, there's something wrong. So we picked him to hospital hapo referral, KU, and then tukaingia. By the time tunaingia, tunampea madaktari pale, you know, I was with the doctors hapo, tukijaribu kumpea first aid. So tukakuwa na madoki hapo. So nikaanza kuona wameanza kunitoa kidiza. Wakatoa wife and my sister, then mimi nilibaki. I was very stubborn. Juu akishika hapa, mimi nashika hapa. I want to help the doctor to make sure things are okay. And then, and the report came that unfortunately, we took him there when he was already passed away. So that was it. It was the hardest thing.
The hardest.
But I never believed, by the way. Yeah. Where is it happened? So when the now doctors told me we meet at the other side, I didn't know the other side knew what happened. Only to realize the other side was at the mortuary. So that's when now it hit me well. And so, the journey began. now another journey.
Mm. Yeah. That must be in a roller coaster of emotions from receiving the good news that you your wife has delivered to going at home with the child. You leave the house in the morning, you're being called, and, you know, your child is not feeling well. Yeah. Those are a lot of emotions for one person. I don't know how you felt at that point.
Let me take you back a little bit.
Yes.
After my wedding, let me give you a story. Kidogo to for like a minute.
Yes.
On my wedding day, I got arrested. On that very day, nikiwa nimevaa nguo za
harusi.
And then, so we went with my wife later to leave, but like when Dani mimi nilienda cell.
What?
Yeah. So now after cell, tukaenda. I remember, juu sasa ATM yangu imepotea, sijui nini nikalipa, nilishikwa juu ya some one vendor did what they did. And then, she was my good friend, funny enough. We didn't have a contract with her. So kushikwa nini, so nikaachiliwa around saa nane. Usiku. So we had purpose to go somewhere. So we now decide to go and look for a lunch in. Tulika tulala hotel ya Thao, nyinyi watu. Hotel ya Thao, and then from there on Tuesday,
yes,
to kind of prayer center because things were very hard. Niliona hii vile tumeanza hii ya marriage, vitu hazi-add up. So watu wakidhan tuko sisi tuko honeymoon, sisi tuko mountain. Went for prayer somewhere in Kikuyu.
Yeah.
Then the following day, my dad passed on. My dad is my late dad. Aka die. So now, I wanted to compare the two scenarios because how I felt when my dad passed on, it was very different on how I felt when my son passed on. I normally say this. We know. One time we will bury our parents because anyway it's life. This has to happen.
Yes.
It is in our back in our conscience we know that this will happen one day. But it never rings that you can bury your own. So when I lost my son is when it hit me that I have lost my own son. I remember when I was called at by the mortuary attendants to go and view now, you know when wale wajui, wacha niwaambie tu juu, hizi ni vitu ziko.
Yeah.
Ukiingia huko ndani, kuna mahali ambapo mtoto, mtu ameaga, anawekwa una prepare, ndio umuone maybe the last time, ndio utoke. Uone mahali amewekwa, kama iko sawa, in case you have anything to say. I'm telling you, I woke up to go view my son and things, I couldn't make it. I just fell and then things never were never the same again from then until God blessed us with another son. Yeah.
But how were you able to cope with the pain and even your wife? I'm sure your wife went through a lot of emotions at that point. It wasn't as easy as as you can imagine. Yes.
Oh, this is what I did. Let me. I normally say my experience can be a bit different from other people's experience and how people handle things. Of course, it's a bit different and. Me, I know there are people who came to comfort us. Oh, you need to see counselor, you need to see ABCD, you need to do ABCD. But me, I looked back. And I remember my father, let me even celebrate my father in faith, because now, you know, he's one of the only father I have. Pastor T is my father in faith. And
yes.
We talked that morning. Akaniambia, Chris, listen, the mystery of life and death is with God. And so the only person who can heal you is God.
Yeah.
So me nikaambia wife niaje si atafanya counseling. Psychology ni God anaelewa. Unajua this one thing to have knowledge through books is another one to have knowledge from him.
Because
Bible inasemanga knowledge is from him.
God,
so as we prayed and we trusted God for healing, I honor all the people who do counseling. I honor them.
Yes.
But on my case we trusted God. Believe me. My wife was the most, I think, ni mtu alikuwa ameumia zaidi. But she's the one who, ndio hata alipona mbele yangu.
Mungu ni nani?
Mungu ni nani.
Mungu ndio ule amsesi.
Mambo ikasonga.
Mambo ikasonga. And I know it took you a period before you even had the second child.
Yeah.
And I can imagine that time God was working on your soul. Awaponye kuponya visiria. Sindio?
Yes.
Alafu the second child came.
Funny enough, okay, us.
Yes.
Us. We never use Acha niseme tu because is a is a, you know, family people are listening or watching.
Yes. Please, please, please.
As we never use, you know, the so-called contraceptives and all this kind of stuff. We never. And so the time we trusted God for another child, funny enough, we were not getting a child. My wife was not conceiving for 2 good years. Something we mpaka tukat we now had to my wife akafika pale na kosa ananiambia hey, niaje twende OC ninamwambia zi si alitupea kwanza huyo 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 anajenga pili I remember my mom in faith was called Mom Claudia, she called me one day na akani prayer anikamwambia mi faith yangu ni I will get a child I don't care how si Abraham waited
yes
sasa mimi miaka mbili na shikwa na pressure. And so nikamwambia wife, you're not seeing a doctor. Na mimi sitaki kusikia story ya daktari, na waheshimu sana, but see, my faith tells me I'll get a child. And then boom, one day.
Father God has happened, restored.
Then he restored, he gave us a boy. Funny enough, you know, I think story my life, I think, and marriage issues, it has been very crazy. Because all the scans were saying, even 2 days to delivery, scans were saying it's a girl.
It's a so baby girl.
At a jina.
Umetengeneza jina
ya mrembo.
Ni ya mrembo.
On, on the day of delivery, a son comes. My boy stayed, I think, for 3-4 days without a name.
Yes.
Yeah. Caesar to Meshindwa because they got admitted again. Siji kuna issue. You know, the devil was still trying to fight, you know, his way because God really restored. Yes. He gave me a Seth.
Yes.
Yeah, in place of Abel. Yeah. You know, when you read when Abel, when Cain killed Abel, Bible God says, God gave them a child in place. Of Abel. It was not another son. It was in place. That was restoration.
Yeah.
So God is in the business of restoration. Whether you lost whatever job, ministry, anything you lost is always in a business of restoration. And mine is literally. No, ile enye aitaji revelation ananijenga boy. Funny enough, my late son and the son I have today was 4 months old. Actually, he got 4 months yesterday. So, sijui mtamwambia birthday, happy
birthday
month. The funny enough, they look alike. Telling you, see the photos. Yeah. Actually, utashanga.
In place.
Literally.
Yourself.
Literally, restoration. Ile.
So God is in a business of restoration.
And it was Kinsey.
Yeah, Kinsey.
Yeah.
God is in a business of restoration.
He has never failed. That is always his business.
Alafu, another thing I'm getting from is that God is in the business of fighting your battles.
Definitely.
God is in the business of healing you. He's so concerned. Me won't be up and say, God is so concerned of your state of your heart that he will do everything to heal you.
Very true.
Unanishangaza umuombea mtoto 2 years akuji.
Akuji.
Finally, after 2 years, Mungu anasema, sasa mume, mko sawa.
Ndiyo hiyo.
Wacha niwalete Kinsey. Kinsey.
Yeah.
In place.
Yes.
In place.
Yeah.
Our God is good.
Very, very.
Our God is able to do.
Nashukuru
exceedingly
God.
Abundantly.
Yes.
Above everything that we could ever think or imagine.
Or ask.
Or ask. Mazee msee mwenyana watch sahi. Ai mazee, I hope his story kubless sana.
Yeah.
You know what? And father goes through emotions. Yeah. Fathers go through, you know, you need to be strong for the family.
Sure.
You need to step in for your wife. And I like that you turn to God.
Yeah.
And God was your father.
Kabisa.
Ah! Nani kama bazu.
Godfather.
Godfather.
God the Father.
He's the God the Father.
Nashukuru Mungu.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
I know, Chris, this is such a wonderful story that you've shared. And I know some people would like even to reach out to you and even connect to this so that you can even work with them. Maybe you can mention social media platform vile wase wanakupata.
Yeah.
Facebook ni nini na pia tunapenda kutuma salamu hapa. Tuma salamu. Pale. Ile kamera.
Goodness.
Sawa. You
of
go.
Course, mimi sims social media sana, but my Facebook. Najua nitaona message yako. Chris Ngao. Chris Ngao. And then on Instagram is Chris Ngao again. On YouTube, I have a channel. It's called Wasia Wangao. It's a Kamba channel. That's where I just lift my voice and, you know, try to voice my idea.
Yes.
And also, I don't know that here you give your number, but anyway.
You can share if you want to.
It's all right. I can share because then Mimi, I'm not a thug. You can come, we can pray together. 0718 47 3952 or 718-47-3952. My name is Chris. You can just reach me. Strictly wacha tupige huduma naweza kusaidia lakini vitu zingine. Bwana Yesu asifiwe.
Haya, tuma salamu Chris.
Oh my goodness. Of course to my dear wife, Eve Ngao, of course, my son. Najua karadi lakini katarada siku moja. Kinsey, and to my mom, Phyllis, and of course my sisters Miriam, sisi tuko wengi. Miriam, Faith, Winnie, Nancy, Nelly, and Brian, my brother, and then of course to my friends, pastors, all pastors were my friends from church, Apostle T, and you know the rest of the pastors there. Yeah. Na mabeste wangu wote.
Karibu kwa Mluya.
I have too many friends, so I can't mention them all.